Hi students, in the last class we discussed about the aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration process. Today onwards we are discussing regarding to the cellular respiration process. That is nothing but we are discussing about the aerobic respiration process. See, this one is also called as cellular respiration. Cellular respiration takes place majorly in three phases. The very first one is called as glycolysis. And the next phase is called as TCA cycle. This one is also called citric acid cycle or tricarboxylic acid cycle. Right? Third one is the electron transport chain. So in a cell, cellular respiration majorly occurs in three phases. The very first phase is glycolysis, the next phase is the TCA cycle, the last one is the electron transport chain. Right? So that is about the cellular respiration. Right? See, today we are discussing about the glycolysis pathway. Glycolysis occurs within the cytoplasm. Why glycolysis occurs within cytoplasm? Because the enzymes are available within cytoplasm, right? So this is the glycolysis pathway. Within the glycolysis pathway, majorly 10 steps are present. Within glycolysis, how many steps are present? 10 steps are present. All these steps are takes place within cytoplasm, right? Remember, within this case, the very first one, we know that glycolysis pathway, when the glucose molecules are entered to the cytoplasm, the glycolysis is started, right? So the very first one is the glucose is converted into glucose 6-phosphate. I thought most of the students are well known about the structure of the glucose. See, in the intermediate level, we don't need the structure, but for better understanding, I am explaining based on the structure, right? So this is one of the CHO, and this is the OH, and this is the H, right? And this is H, OH, right? This is the OH, H, this is the OH, H, CH2, OH. So this is the structure of the glucose. So in the glucose, molecule, totally 6 carbon atoms are present. So this is about the structure of the glucose, right? Within this glucose structure, 6 carbon compounds are present, right? See, the very first step, glucose is converted into glucose 6-phosphate. This step is called as phosphorylation. See, the phosphorylation done by the hexokinase enzyme. Hexo indicates here 6. The enzyme working presence of ATP. So that's the reason why this one is called as kinase. Though the enzymes are working presence of ATP, these enzymes are considered as kinases. Right? So hexokinases. Hexokinases means, see, the enzyme interacting with the 6-carbon-containing compounds. And at the same time, ATP also required. So glucose is converted into glucose 6-phosphate. In that case, ATP is converted into the ADP. Generally, we know the ATP is there. This is the ATP. The ATP converted into the ADP plus PI. ADP plus PI. So the phosphate is donated to the glucose. That's the reason why here ATP converted into ADP, the glucose is converted into glucose 6-phosphate. So in this structure, okay, this is one of the glucose. Once that phosphorylation takes place, right? So here phosphate is binded. Because this is the sixth carbon atom. Okay, so that's the reason why at sixth position phosphate is added. So this one is called as glucose 6-phosphate. glucose 6 phosphate. So this is the structure of the glucose 6 phosphate. This step is called as phosphorylation. See, after that phosphorylation step, next one is the isomerization. See, isomerization is nothing but the glucose is converted into fructose. See, very simple. This is the structure of the glucose. So within this case, the glucose is converted into fructose. Glucose contains the aldehyde group. Aldehyde group is the CHO, right? Glucose contains the aldehyde group. But fructose contains the ketone group. So see, there is an isomerization takes place. Then the glucose 6-phosphate is converted into fructose 6-phosphate. So here glucose 6-phosphate is converted into the fructose 6-phosphate by the phosphohexose isomerase. Phospho means here phosphate group is present. 6 carbon atoms are present. So isomerization reaction is takes place. That's the reason why phosphohexose isomerase enzyme, right? Presence of this enzyme, glucose 6-phosphate is converted into the fructose 6-phosphate. So this reaction is called as isomerization. And next one, fructose 6-phosphate is converted into the fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. Means one of the phosphate is added. Already one phosphate is present. One more phosphate is added. Again this step is called as phosphorylation. So fructose 6-phosphate is converted into fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. Here ATP is converted into ADP because one of the phosphate is donated. So here fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. So at first position, one of the phosphate is added. Already sixth position, phosphate is present. That's the reason why this one is called as fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. So this is the structure of the fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. Remember all of you, this phase, okay, from glucose to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate, okay, within the glycolysis, this phase is called as energy investment phase. Within glycolysis, up to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate formation, from glucose to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate formation, this phase is called as investment phase. And all of you remember, exactly in this phase, energy utilization is takes place. Generally, okay, respiration indicates ATP production is takes place. But within the glycolysis, the very first steps are utilizes the energy. That's the reason why this one is called as investment phase. All of you remember, in these enzymes, the very important enzymes are phosphofructokinase. Is a major enzyme. Hexokinase is also very important enzyme. Remember, these two enzymes are very important for the regulation of glycolysis. One is that hexokinase, other one is the phosphofructokinase. These two enzymes are very important enzymes for the regulation of the glycolysis. Sir, in these two enzymes, which one is the major enzyme? See, phosphofructokinase is the major enzyme. So here hexokinase and the phosphofructokinase enzyme, these two enzymes are very important enzymes which are majorly regulates the glycolysis process. See, the glycolysis is also called Embden-Meyerhof-Parnas pathway. Remember, Embden-Meyerhof-Parnas pathway. Because these three scientists have identified the glycolysis pathway, that's the reason why the glycolysis cycle is also called Embden-Meyerhof-Parnas pathway. Right? So that is about that name of the glycolysis and the scientists of the glycolysis. After that, fructose 1,6-bisphosphate formation. Cleavages takes place. We know this is the 6 carbon compound. This is the 6 carbon compound. The 6 carbon compound is cleaved into the 3 carbon compound and the 3 carbon compound. The 6 carbon compound cleaved into the 3 carbon compound and the 3 carbon compound. So here fructose 1,6 bisphosphate presence of aldolase enzyme. Presence of aldolase enzyme. See, dihydroxyacetone phosphate formation. Other one is the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate formation. Remember, the fructose 1,6 bisphosphate 6 carbon contained compound. Okay, cleaved into 3 carbon compound and the 3 carbon compound. One of the compound name is dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Other one is the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So this reaction is called as cleavage reaction or splitting reaction. This reaction is called as cleavage reaction or the splitting reaction. So here, this is a 6 carbon compound. Exactly here cleavage takes place. Then one of the compound is the dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Other one is the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. Right? So presence of aldolase enzyme, fructose 1,6 bisphosphate is cleaved. It produces the dihydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. Remember, between these two interconversion is takes place. See, sometimes the dihydroxyacetone phosphate is converted into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. Maybe the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is converted into dihydroxyacetone phosphate. So internal conversion is carried out by the phosphotriose isomerase enzyme. Phospho means here phosphate groups are present. Triose means three carbon atoms are present. Isomerization. One compound is, see, having that same molecular formula, but it's showing that differences. So here dihydroxyacetone phosphate, see, converted into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. See, the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate converted into dihydroxyacetone phosphate, because internal arrangement is different. Having molecular formula, having same molecular formula, but the internal arrangement is the different. So that is about that cleavage or splitting. Next one, we'll discuss about the energy production. Means within glycolysis also ATP production takes place. Okay, from conjugation, from here to pyruvate production, okay, there is an energy production takes place. How the energy production takes place, we'll discuss. Or next steps of the glycolysis, we'll discuss. See, in the entire glycolysis, 10 steps are present. 10 steps are present, right? The remaining steps, we'll discuss now. After that, fructose 1,6 bisphosphate cleavage process, here two molecules are produced. One of the molecule is the dihydroxyacetone phosphate, other one is the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. And remember, these are the three carbon contained compounds, and these three carbon contained compounds are involved in that energy production. Remember, the fructose 1,6 bisphosphate produces the dihydroxyacetone phosphate and the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So this one is also converted into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphates are present. So two phosphates are added. For the next reaction, two phosphates are added, right? And two NAD plus are added. Because these are the two molecules, right? Finally produces the 1,3 bisphosphocliflate. Already here one phosphate is present. So we are adding another phosphate. So two molecules, we are adding two phosphates. So for the simple explanation, glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, presence of phosphate, converted into 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate. So here phosphate is added. This one is also called phosphorylation step. This step is also called phosphorylation. And NAD is converted into NADH plus H plus. NAD plus is converted into NADH plus H plus. Right? So here, removal of hydrogen atoms from the substrate. Hydrogen atoms are removed. Two hydrogen atoms are removed. So removal of hydrogen atoms, that one is nothing but oxidation. The reaction is nothing but the oxidation. So here, enzyme name is glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase enzyme, because the enzyme removes the hydrogen atoms. So here, two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphates produces two molecules of 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate. 1,3 bisphosphonylate. So a single compound having two phosphates here. A single compound having two phosphates, right? So that is about that phosphate addition and the NAD, okay, regulation, right? Here the enzyme, okay. The next product is the 1,3 bisphosphonylate. This reaction is called as oxidation reaction. And 1,3 bisphosphonylate, 1,3 bisphosphonylate converted into 3 phosphoglycerate. So here 1,3 bisphosphonylate is converted into 3 phosphoglycerate. In that case, one phosphate is removed. One phosphate is removed from the first position. So the phosphate involving the phosphate group involving the production of ATP. So here ADP is converted into ATP. ADP is converted into ATP. So two molecules of 1,3 bisphosphonylate, two molecules of ADP is added, two molecules of ATP is produced. So finally here two molecules of, okay, 3 phosphoglycerates, two molecules of 3 phosphoglycerates are produced. So here enzyme name is the phosphoglycerate kinase. The enzyme name is the phosphoglycerate kinase. Remember 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate, okay, two molecules are present which are converted into 3 phosphoglycerate, okay, these are two molecules. During the conversion process, two ADP molecules are converted into two ATPs. Two ADP molecules are converted into two ATPs. So here phosphoglycerate kinase is the enzyme. So this step is called as dephosphorylation or substrate level phosphorylation. Dephosphorylation is nothing but the substrate contains one of the phosphate group is removed. So 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate is converted into 3 phosphoglycerate. So we are, okay, the reaction removing the phosphate group, that's the reason why this one is called as dephosphorylation. At the same time, one substrate involved in the synthesis of ATP by the donation of the phosphate group, that one is called as substrate level phosphorylation. That one is called as substrate level phosphorylation. So here the 3 phosphoglycerate again converted into the 2 phosphoglycerate. Simple. Okay, this is the carbon compound, 3 carbon compound. Here phosphate is present. Okay, maybe this is the third one. Here phosphate is present. So, okay, for the next step, here conversion is takes place. So the third carbon, the third carbon contain phosphate shifted to the second carbon. The third carbon contain phosphate shifted to the second carbon. So that's the reason why this one is called as 2 phosphoglycerate. This one is called as 2 phosphoglycerate. So this reaction done by the mutase enzyme. This reaction done by the mutase enzyme. This is one of the isomerization. Same compounds are there, but the phosphate group is shifting from third position to the second position. So this reaction is called as isomerization reaction. This reaction is called as isomerization reaction, right? Then the 2 phosphoglycerate converted into the phosphoenol pyruvate. Simple. From the 2 phosphoglycerate, here two molecules of the 2 phosphoglycerates, two molecules of the 2 phosphoglycerates are present, which are produces the 2 phosphoenol pyruvates and which are removes the 2 water molecules. See, 2 phosphoglycerate converted into phosphoenol pyruvate. Water molecule is removed. Water molecule is removed. So 2 molecules. Here 2 molecules are produced. 2 water molecules are removed. Removal of water molecules. Dehydration. The reaction is called as dehydration. See, the enzyme name is the enolase enzyme. The enzyme name is the enolase enzyme. Always enolase enzyme action requires magnesium ions. Always enolase enzyme requires magnesium ions, right? The phosphoenol pyruvate, presence of pyruvate kinase, 2 pyruvate molecules are produced. 2 pyruvate molecules are produced. So in this step, 2 ADPs are converted into 2 ATPs. Same dephosphorylation. This step is the dephosphorylation or substrate level phosphorylation. I did not mention, I don't have a space here, that's why. Okay, this step is dephosphorylation, or the next one is the substrate level phosphorylation, right? Phosphoenol pyruvate, 2 molecules, okay, presence of 2 ADPs, produces 2 ADPs. Here pyruvate production is takes place. Name of the enzyme is the pyruvate kinase enzyme. Name of the enzyme is the pyruvate kinase enzyme. So here totally how many number of ATPs are produced? Here 2 ATPs are produced. Here 2 ATPs are produced. So in glycolysis, 4 ATPs are produced, right? And 2 NADH plus H plus are produced. 2 NADH plus, H plus are produced. NADH plus, H HBs are produced. So net gain of glycolysis, net gain of glycolysis. Remember here in the investment phase, in glycolysis, in investment phase, glucose is converted into glucose 6-phosphate. There 1 ATP is utilized. Then fructose 6-phosphate is converted into fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. Another ATP is utilized. Totally 2 ATPs are utilized. So if we did the minus, right? So the net gain ATPs in glycolysis is the net gain ATPs in glycolysis is the 2 ATPs. Remember, within the glycolysis, there is no requirement of the oxygen. There is no requirement of the oxygen. See, if the glycolysis is extended, presence of oxygen, TCA cycle will be takes place. The glycolysis, okay, extended without oxygen, there is a lactic acid formation is takes place. In some organisms like yeast, in yeast, alcohol production is takes place, right? See, some bacteria, lactic acid production is takes place. In humans also, anaerobic respiration is takes place, especially in the skeletal muscle, right? So what I'm telling here, see, glycolysis not requires oxygen. TCA cycle definitely requires oxygen. In the last class I explained, right? So this is about that glycolysis process. All I have to remember, in the glycolysis process, okay, totally 10 reactions are there, or 10 steps are there. End of the steps, finally we have the 2 pyruvate molecules. Again, these pyruvate molecules are entered to the TCA cycle. Again, these pyruvate molecules are entered to the TCA cycle. Between the glycolysis and the TCA cycle, there is a reaction is there. That reaction is called as link reaction. The reaction is called as link reaction. So in the next class, we will discuss about that the link reaction and the TCA cycle. Right?